My dear friends, welcome to Rajasekhar classes on formal languages and automata theory. This is lecture number 16. In this lecture, we will try to understand conversion from NFA to DFA. Before discussing this particular procedure, let me try to explain few points. Construction of NFA is very much easier and simpler compared to construction of DFA. Means NFA construction is simple compared to DFA construction. That's what it says. Every DFA is an NFA. Is it correct? Every DFA is an NFA. How will you justify what is the difference between DFA and NFA? In the case of DFA, what is our transition function? Delta Q cross sigma to Q, isn't it? What about NFA transition function? Your NFA transition function is Q cross sigma union to 2 power Q, isn't it? If you observe definitions of DFA and NFA, they differ only in terms of transition function, isn't it? Therefore, this is Q is set and 2 power Q is power set. Power set means set of all subsets of a set. Q, certainly Q presents in 2 power Q, isn't it? Therefore, Q set always presents in its power set. Therefore, every DFA is an NFA. But converse need not true. Means NFA need not be DFA. But you can always construct an equivalent DFA for given NFA. In this class, we will try to understand procedure of conversion from NFA to DFA. Yes, before discussing that procedure, let me solve problems. If I solve problem, you can understand this particular procedure. Therefore, first let me explain a few problems. After discussing those problems, just read this procedure, you can understand. Now we will try to convert NFA. What it says, conversion of NFA to DFA. This is given NFA. For given NFA, you know how to formulate table. Just I formulated table. After formulating table, now let me construct this NFA to this is DFA. I am constructing DFA. This is your question, that is NFA. If you observe procedure in my previous slide, if you compare, initial state and inputs are same for NFA as well as DFA. What is the initial state in given question? That is NFA, Q0. That Q0 must be the initial state in corresponding DFA. What are the inputs in your NFA? A comma B. That A comma B, certainly they must be, you can have same inputs in corresponding DFA. Therefore, let me repeat it again. Q0 and A comma B means initial state and inputs are same in NFA as well as DFA. Here I have Q0 initial state, just I am copying Q0 initial state. Here I have inputs A comma B, just I am copying A comma B. Again and again, let me repeat. Initial state and inputs are same, just I am copying. What is this? Delta dash. How can I say this? Now I have to calculate. What is the procedure? Delta dash of Q comma A equal to delta of Q comma A. This is delta dash. This is delta. Therefore, how can I say delta dash of Q comma A? In the sense, I must find delta dash of Q naught on A. What is delta dash of Q0 on A? According to formula in my previous slide, that is delta of Q0 on A. What is my delta of Q0 on A? Q0. Just I am writing Q0. What is delta dash of Q0 on B? That is delta of Q0 on B. Q0 on B is Q0 Q1. Just I am copying down Q0 Q1. Yes, after this, what I have to do? Just I must find transitions for Q0 as well as Q0 Q1. For these states, I have to find. Anyway, Q0 already discussed. Now, I must copy this Q0 Q1 here. Just see, here I am finding. Now, this Q0 Q1 can be treated as a single state, not two states, isn't it? I am considering that one as single state. Just I am copying down this one. Again, I must find Q0 Q1 on A, Q0 naught, Q1 on B. How can I find delta dash of Q naught, Q1 on A? According to formula in my previous slide, delta of Q0 on A union delta of Q1 on A. What is delta of Q0 on A? That is Q0, isn't it? What is delta of Q1 on A? Q1 on A is its phi. Q0 union phi means I am getting Q0, isn't it? In similar manner, I must find delta dash of Q0, Q1 on B. What is this? I am finding this one. What is the procedure? Delta of Q0 on B union delta of Q1 on B. Delta of Q0 on B means what? B means Q0, Q1. Q0, Q1 union delta of Q1 on B means what? Q1 on B means Q2, isn't it? Q2. Therefore, if I take union of these two sets, Q0, Q1, Q2. Therefore, this is Q0, Q1, Q2, isn't it? Now, what I have to do? Now, we completed Q0, Q1. Q0 anyway completed. Now, just take this one here. I am taking this set. Again, what does it mean? Delta dash of Q0, Q1, Q2 on A. According to formula, that is delta of Q0 on A union delta of Q1 on A union delta of Q2 on A, isn't it? Just if you find union of all those things on A, what will you get? You will get this one, delta of Q0 on A, delta of Q0 on A, that is essentially Q0 union Q delta of Q1 on A. Q1 on A is phi, therefore I must write phi. Q2 on A, Q2 on A is also phi, therefore I will get set Q0. That's what it says, I will get Q0, isn't it? Therefore, let me erase first. Now, delta dash of Q0, Q1 on B, I have to discuss. Delta dash of Q0, Q1, Q2 on B. How will it be? Just write delta of Q0 on B, union delta of Q1 on B, union delta of Q2 on B, isn't it? Q0 on B means what? Q0 on B means Q0, Q1, isn't it? Q0, Q1 union Q1 on B. This is Q1 on B. Q1 on B means what? Q2, isn't it? What is that? Q2 on B. Q2 on B means phi. Q0, Q1, Q2. You will get this one, isn't it? Now, what does it mean? Now, you are getting this one. Is there any other states here to write here? There is no other states. Therefore, now to write, I don't have any other states to keep here. Therefore, I am stop here itself. Which one is final state in given question? Q2 is final state. Therefore, I must keep, as Q2 is appearing in this particular state, therefore, this must be a final state. From here onwards, this is a single state. This is also a single state. This is also a single state. Therefore, what does it mean? Ultimately, Q2, as Q2 is final state in given question, wherever that Q2 appears, in whichever set that Q2 appears, treat them as final sets. Here, you don't have Q2, it cannot be final state. It is a final state as Q2 present in the this particular set. Again, let me say, this is single state, this is single state, this is single state. Therefore, this can be a DFA. This is your NFA. Your NFA is translated into, or your NFA is converted into DFA. Yes. Now, let me discuss another procedure for same problem. Let me say this is a problem. This is known as subset construction method. How many states are there? There are three states, Q0, Q1, Q2. If there are three states, how many possible subsets are there? Eight. There will be eight possible subsets. If there are n elements, what are the possible subset? 2 power n. As there are 3 states, 2 power 3 means you will get 8 subsets. Just form the subsets for this particular set. That is power set. Power set means what? Set of all subsets. This is empty set, single element sets, 2 element sets, 3 element sets. Totally how many sets are we getting? We are getting totally 8 sets. Just keep those sets like this. 5, Q0, Q1, Q2. I am keeping that 8 sets like this. Isn't it? Yes, which one is final state here? Q2. Wherever Q2 appears, make it final. Wherever that, in whichever set is it's appearing, make it is final. Is Q2, therefore final. Here also Q2 is present, final. Here also Q2 is present, final. Here also Q2 is present, final. Just designate them as final states. Final states. After that, what you have to do? It's simple procedure. Empty set on any input, you will get empty set only. Q0 on A. What will you get? Q0 on A means you will get Q0 on A, you will get Q0, Q0 on A, you will get Q1. Just like this. Q0 on B. Q0 on B means what? You are getting Q0 only. Just formulate like this. Q1 on A. What is my Q1 on A? There is no transition, therefore empty set. Q1 on B. Q1 on B means you are getting Q2. In that manner, I think you can formulate this one. How will you formulate for multiple this one? Q0, Q1 on A. Q0, Q1 on A means you have anyway Q0 on A. What is this Q0 on A? This one? Q1 on A. Just take union. Q0, Q1, Q2. Q0, Q1 on B means what? Q0, Q1 on B means anyway you have Q0 on B, Q1 on B. Just take union of this one, Q0, Q2. Just you can formulate this table, just imitate this procedure. After formulating, just name, instead of writing these big sets, let me say A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Just I am renaming them A, B, C, D, E, F. A means empty set, B means set Q0, singleton Q0, C means singleton Q1, D means singleton Q2, E means set of Q0, comma Q1, and F means Q0, Q2. Just I am keeping like this, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, like this. Capital A and small a, capital A and small a, you are getting 5. But what is 5? 5 means A, that's what I am writing. Capital A and small b, you are getting 5, but what is 5? 5 means A, I am writing 5. Capital B on small a, capital B on small a, you are getting Q0, Q1. What is your Q0, Q1? Q0, Q1 is, Q0, Q1 is E, isn't it? Therefore, I am writing E. Capital B on small b, capital B on small b, capital B and small b, I am getting Q0, but what is Q0? Yeah, I am saying B, isn't it? Just rename the states. After renaming, what you have to do, it is simpler, simple procedure. Here, which one is starting state? Your Q0 is starting state. Which one is designated as starting state? Q0 is renamed as B. Just take starting state, arrow, this is initial state. B on A, what you are getting? B on A, B on A, you are getting E. B on B, B on B, you are getting B, isn't it? Now, I must always identify reachable states from initial state. Which one is initial state? B. From B, I can reach to E. From B, I can reach to B also. Now, I need only transitions for from starting state. Now, consider E. What are the inputs E? On E, on small a is capital E, small b is capital F. Just I am copying down. Again, what about this B is completed. From B, E is reachable. From B is reachable anyway. From another state, from B, F is reachable. For F, I must write. From F, E, B is there. I am writing E, B. All other states are not reachable from B. Therefore, I am removing all other states. Just I am keeping only these states B, E, F. Why? Because other states are not reachable from. Just copy down like this. These states you have to keep. Therefore, you will get reachable states. Again, let me repeat. I need only reachable states from initial state. Here, initial state is B, isn't it? This is known as subset construction method. In similar manner, I can find this is NFA. For this NFA, I can always find DFA as I discussed in my previous slides. Just try to solve this one. Again, this is assignment questions. Try to solve this one. These questions also. There are three questions. These three NFAs. Try to convert into DFA. Thank you very much.